सुप्रभे गौरचंद्राय राधिकाय तदागे कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तदभक्ताय नमो नमः। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल माय मिलियंस ऑफ दंडवत प्रणाम इन द लोटस फीट ऑफ माय परमाराध्यतम गुरुदेव ओम विष्णु पाद अष्टोत्तर श्रीमद भक्ति प्रज्ञान केशव गोस्वामी महाराज and same in the lotus feet of my Shiksha Guru, Nitya Lila Pravishta Om Vishnu Parsi Smad Bhakti Vedan Swami Maharaj. I want that I should speak in Hindi and Vishnu will translate for all. I know that most of you know Hindi. So,
he will translate.
आजकल कलयुग है, लोगों को आयु उम्र बहुत छोटी हो गई है और खान पान रहन सहन इत्यादि बहुत निम्न कोटि का हो जाने से लोगों की बुद्धि भ्रष्ट हो जाएगी। अधिकांश लोग दुर्भागा है और तरह तरह के उपद्रव चारों तरफ से घेरे हैं, अपने पड़ोसियों से विवाद और सब मामला मुकदमा रोग तरह तरह के, और सबसे बड़ी बात इस कलयुग में जो धोखेबाज हैं, जो भी रेप केस में दो तो चार पांच बार जिन पर केस उठ चुका है, जो अभी त्रिनिदाद में पकड़े गए हैं, वहां पर रख दिए गए हैं जेल में, ऐसे ऐसे लोगों को लोग करोड़ों करोड़ों रुपया देते हैं और गुरु मानते हैं, उनको तनिक भी ज्ञान नहीं होता ये कैसे गुरु चाहिए। सब शास्त्रों में विद्वान हो जो अपने शिष्यों के संदेह को सदा के लिए दूर कर दे, भगवान की अनुभूति हो जो अपने हृदय से लोगों के हृदय में कृष्ण को दे दे, और संसार के जितने विषय हैं उनसे अनासक्त हो, ये सब गुरु के लक्षण है। तो इनसे तो कोई संबंध ही नहीं, शराब पीना, मदिरा मांस खाना, ठाकुर जी का भोग नहीं लगाना, ये सब आजकल के गुरुओं के काम है। जेल में जाना तो कोई साधारण बात है, आप लोग इन लोगों से सावधान रहेंगे। प्राचीन काल की बात है कि एक समय हिरण्यकश्यपु का भाई हिरण्याक्ष था, महाबलवान। जब पृथ्वी प्रलय काल में रसातल में चली गई तो उनको ऊपर सतह में लाने के लिए भगवान विष्णु के रूप वराह के रूप में जाकर के अपने दांतों में पृथ्वी को रख करके ले आ रहे थे। उस समय हिरण्यकश्यपु उनसे युद्ध करना चाहा, भगवान ने जल्दी से आकर के पृथ्वी के सतह पर पृथ्वी को रख दिया और उसे मार डाला। उसके शरीर को राजभवन में ले गए और उसे लिटा दिया और कफन उड़ा दिया, सफेद कपड़े उड़ा दिए। सभी लोग रोने लगे, कोई समझाने वाला नहीं। हिरण्यकश्यपु शास्त्रों का ज्ञाता था किंतु फिर भी असुर था, मानता नहीं था उपदेशों को। वो काजे तो दीर्घति हमारा भैया प्राप्त हुआ, इसे तो स्वर्गलोक मिलेगा, रोने की कोई जरूरत नहीं है। तुम लोगों को एक कहानी सुनाता हूँ, सुनो, आप लोग भी मन देकर के इसे सुनेंगे। प्राचीन काल में सुजग्य नामक एक राजा थे। वे पृथ्वी का एक छत्र राजा सम्राट बनना चाहते थे। पास ही में एक और उनके बराबर का बलवान व्यक्ति था राजा, उसको हरा देने से चक्रवर्ती हो जाते। किंतु युद्ध में ये सुजग्य मारे गए, अंग छिन्न भिन्न हो गए। उनको लाकर के राजभवन में लाया और वो सभी लोग रोने लगे। इसी समय में जम महाराज 5 वर्ष का बालक का रूप धारण करके वहां आए और पूछा, अरे आप लोग किस लिए रो रहे हैं, किस लिए रो रहे हो? कोई बतलाए नहीं। एक वृद्ध ने कहा कि तुम नहीं समझे, वो अभी 5 वर्ष का लड़का है, तुम जाओ खेलो। तो मैं तो जितना समझता हूं आप लोग कोई नहीं समझता, आप आखिर बतलाओ तो जो किस लिए रो रहे हैं। तो वो मर गए हैं, इसलिए उनके विरह में शोक में सभी लोग रो रहे हैं। मर गए हैं, कलकत्ता गए हैं, बंबई गए हैं, न्यूयॉर्क गए हैं, लौटेंगे कब? ओ, वो तो अब नहीं लौटेंगे, झूठे, लौटेंगे क्यों नहीं? तो नहीं, वो अब मृत्यु को प्राप्त हो गए हैं, नहीं लौटेंगे। उन्होंने कहा, जी झूठ बोलते हो, ये तो यहीं पर सोए हुए हैं, उठाओ और बातचीत करो। उन्होंने कहा, अरे नहीं, इसके अंदर में जो आत्मा थी, प्राण मैं, वो निकल गया। बात बड़े सुख की बात है, जो शरीर को कहते हो, जिसी को पालन पोषण किया, इसी को पुत्र पति भाई बंधु समझा, वो तो यहां पर पड़ा हुआ है। और जिसको कहते हैं कि आत्मा वो चली गई, उसको कभी देखा कितना लंबा था, कितना चौड़ा था, गोरा था या सावला था, उसकी आत्मा कैसी थी? तो नहीं, कभी नहीं देखा। तो नहीं हुआ देखा तो लोग, करोड़ों लोग मरते हैं, उनके लिए क्यों नहीं रोते? और करोड़ों वर्ष तक सारे पृथ्वी के लोग रोएंगे तो लौट करके आ जाएगा, नहीं आएगा? इसलिए इसके लिए शोक मत करो। ऐसे ही हम लोगों को कोई मरने के बाद में सोचना चाहिए कि आत्मा अजर अमर है। वो कहीं श्लोक में जन्म ले लिया तो भी आप उसे नहीं समझेंगे। इसके लिए शोक न करके भगवान का भजन कीजिए, जिससे आप जीवन में सुखी और शांति हो सके। बिना भगवत भजन के यदि कोई कहता है कि मैं सुखी हूं, तो वो झूठ बोलता है, कोई सुखी नहीं हो सकता है। हाँ, थोड़ा सा बोल दो तब फिर बोलेंगे। ठीक है।
श्री गुरुदेव इज एक्सप्लेनिंग दैट इन दिस कल युग वी आर वेरी अनफॉर्चुनेट, आवर लाइफ स्पैन इज वेरी शॉर्ट एंड आवर लाइफ लिविंग and the food that we eat, all of that is of very low quality compared to what in the previous ages people used to, the way they used to live and eat. Our intelligence is also very low level, and most of the people are very, very unfortunate. And all around us, there's so many kind of conflicts between neighbors, between nations, between communities, within our home, all the time. There are fights, conflicts, so many different type of cases. People are fighting against each other. And on top of all of this, we are suffering from so many kind of diseases. The main symptom in this Kali Yuga is that people will be very duplicitous and they will be cheaters. Nowadays, there are so many so-called gurus who have very abominable character. They are engaged in all kind of sinful activities, like meat eating, drinking, and they have also made visits to prisons and lived there for many times, but still people worship them and they are considered gurus. So we should be very, very careful from such people. A guru should have realizations. He should be very expert in scriptures and should be able to remove all the doubts of his disciples. In Satyuga, there were two brothers, Hiranyakashipu and Hiranyaksha. And Hiranyaksha had submerged the earth under Indrasata. So to deliver the earth, the Supreme Lord appeared in the form of Varahadev. And when he was taking the earth out from the water, Hiranyaksha came and they both had a fight. And finally the Supreme Lord killed him and established the earth on the surface of the water. So when Hiranyaksha died, he was taken to his palace and he was covered in the white cloth. And all his relatives, his wives and children, they were all crying. There was no one to console them. There was immense amount of distress. That time his younger brother Hiranyakashipu, he came. He was very intelligent, very knowledgeable, but at the same time he was a demon because he did not used to believe in the existence of the Supreme Lord and surrender unto him. So he believed that his brother has gone to heavenly planets. So he told his family members that you should not cry. Let me narrate a story to you. So he told them that once upon a time there was a king called Suyagya, who was the king of the entire world. He wanted to become the king of the entire world, and to do so he had to defeat another king in a neighboring country. So they had a fight, a big battle, but unfortunately in that battle, instead of winning the battle, this king Suyagya, he lost the battle and he died. When he was brought to his palace, all his family, they were all crying. And at that time, Yam Maharaj, the Lord of Death, he came in the form of a 5-year-old boy. And he asked them that, why are you all crying? So they all said, oh, the king has gone. He has left. So he said, he has left. He has gone. Where has he gone? Has he gone to Calcutta, to Delhi, to New York? Where has he gone? So they said, no, you will not understand. You are a little boy. He has gone from this world and he will never come back. So when the boy went a little ahead, he saw the body of the king was lying down. He said, who is this? They said, he is the king. They said, so you can think that I am a fool? You just said that he is gone, he will never come back, but he is lying here. They said, no, actually his soul has left. So he said, oh, his soul has left. So did you see the soul? Did you see what form the soul had? What was the height of the soul? What was its weight? What was the color? So they all said, no, we have never seen the soul. So this little boy, who was actually the Lord of Death, he said, the soul that none of you had ever seen has left. You had no relationship with that soul. So why are you crying? And the body with which you had a relationship, that body is lying here. And even if you cry for millions of lifetimes, and even if all the people in this world cry, still that soul will not come back. So why should you cry? So Guru Maharaj is saying that similarly, we should also understand that soul is eternal. And when someone leaves this body, we should understand that by all our lamentation, that will not come back. So we should not lament in that case. And we should instead engage our life in worshipping the Supreme Lord in His bhajan. Because without chanting of the holy name, without doing bhajan, we can never become happy.
When Vishnu, in the form of Varahadev, that is, he killed his brother Hiranyaksha. From then, Hiranyakaspu, always thinking that Vishnu is my enemy. He has a son son was very like lucky that he was, when he was in the womb of his mother for 60,000 years, Naradrishi instructed him all Ved, Upanishad, Shastra and everything. So from childhood that boy was very religious minded. He used to chant, meditate always Sri Krishna, always doing kirtan. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. But Hiranyakashipu, he warned him not to have any relation of that Vishnu, he is my enemy. But this boy Prahlad Maharaj never heard his instructions and used to daily, every moment, chanting, remembering, doing kirtan of Krishna. So he became very, very angry. He wanted to kill that boy for this. He asked, who has trained you? Who has given such instruction to chant and remember Vishnu? My guru, your Gurudev Sandamarkh has told. Then Prahlad Maharaj told, that kind of guru cannot instruct like this. They are always like their forefathers, eating same thing and always engaged in worldly things, intoxications. How they can realize Krishna and how they can meditate Krishna? They can never. Nate vidu swartha gatim hi Vishnu durashayaje bahirarthamanina andhaja thaitindhai upaniyamanasu krutam nipatta. They always, what Shruti Vedas has told for that kind of third class persons, that if he will do five sacrifice for Indra and other devata, you can go to heaven. But they don't know that even from swarga, they will have to come down in this world. Not in human form, but dogs, cats, hogs, pigs and other animal species, you will have to come. They don't know. So, these kinds of guru, how they can instruct me? They are like, if a blind person is going anywhere and any another blind person is showing his path, then both of them will go to deep and they will die. Similarly, a guru like this, in this world, whole world we see gurus like this. Those who have done very high class of Sukriti, good activities, only they can go to real guru. Otherwise they will go to bogus gurus who don't have any relation with Krishna and they take meat, eggs, wine, smoking and everything and worldly worshipping them. So you should always be careful from that class of guru. So he told, only those who are pure bhakta of Krishna, if anyone go to them and take their feet dust and they will take path from that dust, only they can realize Krishna and they can tell like this. These bogus guru cannot. Then Hiranyakashipu became very, very angry and wanted to kill that boy, ordered army, or kill him at once. They tried but could not. He was given to an elephant in front of. But elephant, what? Sulha. Smell and run away from there. They gave him, they put very poisonous snakes. But they also returned back from there. Hrinakshipu, there was a sister. He has a wound that she will not be burned in fire. She told, "Oh brother, don't be worried. I'm taking him in my lap and entering in fire. He entered, but Prahlad Maharaj was saved and she was. Oh, that is Holika. From that Holika, now we play holy and enjoy. Then he tried so many things, but he could not. Then in the last, their guru told, "Oh, this is a very small boy. He does not understand. Or father has gone Shukracharya anywhere. When he will return back, oh, very easily he will change the
mind
of that boy." Then Hiranyakashipu was fearing from that boy and sent him again to Guru. Now he was turning him Sham Dam Dand Bhed Niti. What?
Politics.
Duplicity.
Hypocrisy.
All these things. But Prahlad was not hearing. He was always remembering the teachings of Srila Narada Goswami. One day, the two gurus, Sandavart, they went to any other place and told Prahlad that you are monitor, you should look after these boys. Oh, we are coming very soon. Then all the boys become very happy and they wanted to play. And they told Prahlad Maharaj, "Oh, we should play. We have chance." Then Prahlad Maharaj, "Oh, you are playing whole life and you will play whole life. I want to tell you something and you should hear." And then he began to tell all boys, demon boys, "Oh, calm and quiet," and he began to hear. Kaumaram Acharit Pragat Brahman Bhagavatan Iha Durbham Mansam Janma Tadak Arthadam Adhu. What meaning? That all persons, all living beings from boyhood, they should remember, chant and meditate Krishna. Why? They ask that when we will be old, then we will chant, remember. Why in these days we should play and try to study how to make money? All these things. He told that in old days you cannot do anything. Your body will be old, without a stick you cannot walk. And you cannot sit straight. How you will do bhajan? This body is a rotten body. This is a bag of urine, blood, stool and blood and so many things. But in this body, oh, soul and super soul is there. If anyone will practice from beginning in the guidance of a very qualified guru, Sadguru, then he can realize soul and super soul, Krishna there. Soul are so many and super soul Krishna is one, but everywhere he is. So we should only try, especially this human's form will give you paramartha,
supreme goal,
transcendental.
Paramarth means the service of Krishna, eternal service. And you will be happy. In any other species of life, you cannot be happy and not be happy. So practice from very beginning. They told the Prabhu, Prahlad Bhai, brother Prahlad, now we want that we should study hypocrisy, duplicity and diplomacy, Rajniti.
Politics.
Now we should try to how to be happy in this world. Prahlad Maharaj told, we should not try for that. If without invitation, old is coming and also death is coming. So many kinds of sufferings are coming without invitation. In the same way, if happiness is there by your previous activities, then happiness must come. If you don't want even say it will come, then why to nasht karna? Why to waste your time? Don't waste your time. You should all know, very soon you will be old. You were baby-like first, and after you became 5 years old. Now this young age, and after that old age. Old age, in old age, no beauty. Beauty will be gone. Teeth will gone. Eyesight will be less. If you want to take anything, but you cannot digest, how can you do bhajan? So from the beginning of life, you should try to remember chanting. Especially if our umar, life is 100 years. Suppose, now our life has become more or less 50, 60, 80, not more than that. Very rare those who are 100, 102, 105, 125. 105, 150 we cannot cross. Never. So, if we have 100 years life, suppose 50 years goes in vain in sleeping, all sleep, and those who take wine and other things, no limit of sleeping. They are in life, they are like dead. And 50 years in these vehicles. From childhood up to be a qualified person in a study and other things, 20 years goes. And in old age, from 80 to 100, we become so old that we cannot do anything. So only 10 years remaining, and in 10 years to marry a beautiful lady to a very beautiful husband, make children, and to support and nourish and educate them, when you will do bhajan? So, better very beginning we should do. Also, then question they, Prahlad, how you knew all these things? Or Guru has not told anything about this? Where you knew? Then he told, that in the womb of my mother, I was about 60,000 years in the womb, and Narad instructed me all these things. So I have learned this. Especially, if you want to meditate Krishna, then we'll have to accept a very qualified guru. That symptom I have told. And always serve guru. What you have, you should all offer to in the Lord's feet of Gurudev. And in his guidance, you should chant. Remember and do meditation and other things. Then your life will be successful. So you should chant, you should follow me and do kirtan. What kirtan? Jai Jai Radha Ramana Hari Ho. Jai Jai Radha Ramana Hari Ho. By whom? you have received so much power that you are not fearing? Oh, his power of all living entities, his your also power, everyone's power. Oh, where he is? Everywhere he is. But I am not seeing him. Oh, you cannot see, but I am seeing. Is he in this pillar? Oh, yes, Father, he is in this pillar. Oh, I see. And then he? Smash the pillar and a roaring sound. Roaring sound. Okay. And he saw no animal, no man, mixed. Oh, his face was like a lion and this body like man. And he was roaring and he catch hold of Hiranyakashipu and very easily he took him on his lap. At that time, no day, no night.
Dusk time.
And not in a sky and not in on the hill. Not in the house and not out of house. On the door. Not by any weapon. Only by his nails. At once he. No any month or leap year. And thus he killed. Because he has so boom. And at once by nails he took him. He heard the
door
and took his intestine and began to roar. And from his jata, fire skill lapate.
Flames of fire.
Come. All were very much anxious. They feared. Then Brahma was seeing Brahma, Shankar and Lakshmi, all others. Brahma told, O Shankar, you should go and pacify. So why not you are with me? He told that. Oh, I am fearing. Oh, I am also fearing. I have not seen him as angry as he is today. Then he called Prahlad and told, oh my dear son, oh Lakshmi Devi, oh you are his very near and dear wife, you should go and pacify. Oh, today I have not seen like this, I cannot go. Then he told Prahlad, he is your father, for you he has come. You should go and pacify. Now happily and boldly, he went and jumped in the lap of Nrisimhadev. At once Nrisimhadev was pacified. Tears from eyes came. Oh Prahlad, I have made late. Your father has tortured you so much. So, now he is killed. I want that after him you will be the king. So what boon you want, I will give. Because my this darshan is amogh,
infallible.
Then Prahlad Maharaj told, laughing, smiling, oh Prabhu, why you are cheating me? I am not a businessman that for a pice or 2 pice or for 1 rupee I will give something. I am not that class of business person. I want that if I have any desire to have from you anything, it should go away. Oh, there is no worldly desire, I know. Even you should ask anyone. Then he told, my father has tortured me and he was against you, so please liberate him. Oh, he has been liberated because you, first class Uttam Adhikari Vaishnava. So in your dynasty, 21 generation of father and mother will be liberated without anything. And those who are Madhyam Adhikari, Vaishnav, in their dynasty, 14 generation will be liberated. And those who are
Kanishta,
a very
neophyte,
low class of Vaishnav, they have taken initiation and diksha, but no realization, nothing. Oh, even for them, 7 dynasty of father and mother will be liberated. So don't. You should have any boon. Then he told, oh, Prabhu, all the persons, all the human persons and living beings are suffering so much. Death and birth coming. So they are very unhappy. I want that you should liberate them, and instead of them, I will take their all bad activities fraught, and I will be in this world suffering all these things. Oh, he told the Prahlad, this is very hard for me. So I am giving this boon that who will hear this story and what I have told, and you have this sambhav, this
dialogue.
They must be liberated. Gaur Prema. So, my request is, you should not think that I am this body. But in this body, Krishna and yourself is there. Very soon, you should select any good qualified guru and if in guidance, start at once Krishna chanting and other things. Because Krishna is very merciful, very powerful. In a moment he can destroy whole universes and millions of universes, or he can again create. He has all good qualities. He has invested his all power, all mercy, and all qualities in Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama.
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
If you will chant this, but condition is one. Don't eat meat. F. Don't serve alcohol.
Alcohol, wine, tobacco.
All these things, smoking and other things. Never. Meat means me eat. To whom you will eat, they will eat you. And F. X. What they are? Om. They are children. Krishna has not made for to eat. So you should avoid all these things. And chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. And thus Krishna prema will come. You will realize yourself and Krishna. And never be old, and never you will return back to this world. Go Pramanande.
Hare Krishna, first of all, I like to thank all of you who have taken time in your all busy life to come and hear Harikatha from a realized soul. As you have heard, we will have a fire sacrifice. Some people are interested in taking Harinam from Srila Gurudev. So if you are interested, please come tomorrow at 9 o'clock in the morning. We'll have a fire sacrifice for you. And tomorrow evening, we have another devotee there here. They also live nearby. Srila Gurudev will have another program. So you all can enjoy. Devotee's name is, they are here, Lakshmi Devi and Vinod Bihari Patel.
address.
So their address and their directions, you can ask them. They have. So please take opportunity to use this time to make your life successful. And please, on 29th May to 3rd June, the reason Gurudev is here, we, you know, have his mercy. He is struggling at such an advanced age for the benefit of all of us, and we are getting this opportunity we may not get next time. From 29th June, May to 3rd June, we'll have 6-day festival from morning till evening. It's cultural program with classes. There will be 9 or 10 sannyasis that all will be giving classes throughout the day. There will be breakfast, lunch and dinner. So please take time to come and associate and learn from them what you can, how you can make your life successful, how you can really get out of this cycle of birth and death. Tomorrow is Ekadashi and Mahadwadashi. So we will be fasting from grains and beans, and that is one small item that we follow in restrictions and regulations to be in this path of devotional practice.
Summer camp for the children.
There is also a summer camp, summer bhakti camp for children that we have arranged. As you have heard from time and time after, this Prahlad Maharaj was 5 years old and he was giving this instruction that we still at this age, 50 years old, we cannot really take that and follow. So this is at least our duty to see if our 5 year old kids can do what we could not do in our lifetime. So this, for that reason we have started the summer bhakti camp. There will be Gurukul from California. The teachers will be coming and giving the instructions, their introduction to Bhagavad Gita, arts and crafts, devotional music and devotional practices they will learn. They will also learn some mridanga and other crafts. So please bring your son. Their classes are from 11 to 4. There is a registration fee for that. So if you can bring your kids, then please contact Subal Sakha Prabhu, they are here, Vishnu Prabhu also, and you can bring your kids, fill up the form. That's from 11 to 4, 29th May through 3rd June, 6 days. They will be given lunch and they can attend all other programs throughout the day. Gaur Premanande
Gaje Radha Ramana Hari Govinda Jai Jai.
Hare Rama, 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 Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.